હાઈ લેવલે થઈ ગયું છે. અને 2017 માં કોંગ્રેસની સરકાર આવે એટલે પહેલા તો એજ્યુકેશન ફીના ધોરણ પર કંટ્રોલ થવો જોઈએ અને મહિલા એજ્યુકેશન ટોટલ ફ્રી હોવું જોઈએ એવો મારો વિચાર છે.
I believe આ વેબસાઇટ આજે લોન્ચ કરવાનો પ્લાન હતો. સો સોરી વી કુડ નોટ એક્સપ્લેન ટુ યુ પહેલા. સર્વપ્રથમ ગુડ આફ્ટરનૂન ટુ એવરીવન. ઇટ ઇઝ ઇન્ડીડ તમે બોલો અડબંતર રોડ ચાલુ કરું ચાલુ કરું. ગુડ આફ્ટરનૂન ટુ એવરીવન. ગુજરાતીમાં બોલવા પ્રયત્ન કરીશ પણ થોડું ઘણું ઇંગ્લિશ બોલાઈ જાય તો માફ કરશો. ઇટ ઇઝ ઇન્ડીડ એ પ્રિવિલેજ ટુ બી બેક ઇન બરોડા. હું અહીંયા 1956 ભણવા આવેલો વિદ્યાનગરથી. આઈ સ્ટડી હિયર એટ મહારાજા સયાજીરાવ યુનિવર્સિટી 2 ઇન હાઈસ્કૂલ 6 ઇન સાયન્સ ફેકલ્ટી. Got my master's in physics in 1964 and it's a homecoming for me. So thank you for the opportunity. Coming to this hotel, I saw a building next door to the hotel called Ganga Nivas. In Ganga Nivas, I met my wife for the first time. I remember I was young on a bicycle, about 20 years old, and I saw this girl. She had washed her hair. She was 19. I was on a bicycle, and that day I decided I'm going to marry that girl, and that's what happened. So she is with me today. I told her that I hope to remember this house. So we have lots of fond memories of Baroda. I'm delighted to be here along with my colleagues here from Congress Party. I want to thank them for organizing this event. We also have several young colleagues with me from Ahmedabad and other places. And the purpose today is to begin conversation with people of Gujarat કે જેથી એ લોકો પાસેથી મેનિફેસ્ટો માટે ઇનપુટ મળી શકે. આઈડિયા રાહુલ ગાંધીનો છે. ચારેક વીક પહેલા મારા પર એનો ફોન આવ્યો કે ભાઈ વી શુડ લિસન ટુ ધી વોઇસીસ ઓફ પીપલ ઇન ગુજરાત. આઈ વોન્ટ યુ ટુ હેલ્પ ઓર્ગેનાઇઝ ઇટ. એટલે પછી ધેન આઈ કોલ મધુસૂદનભાઈ મિસ્ત્રી, હિમાંશુભાઈ, મૌલિનભાઈ, દિનેશભાઈ, દીપકભાઈ અને બધાને, અને ફાઇનલી વિથ ધ હેલ્પ ઓફ રોહન એન્ડ એવરી વન વી કુડ ઓર્ગેનાઇઝ અ પ્રોગ્રામ. 5 દિવસનો પ્રોગ્રામ છે. શરૂઆત કરીએ છીએ બરોડાથી. બરોડા ઇઝ અવર ફર્સ્ટ સિટી. એટલે તમારી સાથે મળ્યા પછી વી આર મીટિંગ વિથ ફ્યુ હંડ્રેડ પીપલ ફ્રોમ કોંગ્રેસ એન્ડ ફ્રેન્ડ્સ ઓફ કોંગ્રેસ વર્કર્સ એન્ડ ઓલ. પછી વી આર મીટિંગ સમ ઇન્ટેલેક્ચ્યુઅલ્સ. We are meeting business people. પછી કાલે વી વિલ ગો ટુ અમદાવાદ. પછી વી વિલ ગો ટુ રાજકોટ, જામનગર એન્ડ સુરત. આ 5 સિટીમાં વી વોન્ટ ઇન્ટરેક્શન્સ વિથ પીપલ. તમારી દ્રષ્ટિએ શું કરવું જોઈએ ગુજરાતમાં? બીકોઝ ગુજરાત હેઝ ડન fairly well. It is because Gujaratis do well. Gujaratis do well in Gujarat, Mumbai, Calcutta, Middle East, England, America, Africa. The Gujaratis have been doing well for generations. Mara Babuji, 1930 ma, Gujarat chodi, ane Orissa, kaam sodhwa gaya. Vichar karo to ye jamana ma, Gujarati had entrepreneurial instinct. And this continues. But I believe Gujarat could do much better if government policies were in tune with the needs of the Gujarati people. So this initiative is all about listening to the voices of the people. Lokone shu kehu chhe, manifesto vishe. Lokona shu vicharo chhe on education, on health, small scale industry, environment, employment. All of these are very important topics. And apne je approach leye chhe, e hati pan traditional approach chhe bari drishti. According to me, Gujarat is at crossroads, India is at crossroads, and world is also at crossroads because of the technology. Technology is moving so fast, whether it is cell phone, smartphone, or genetically modified seed, or tissue culture, biotech, nanotech, materials, everything is changing human progress rapidly. We are not equipped to respond. The main thing is, how do we build future for India? Do we build based on the old paradigm or we create new paradigm? World over, everyone is searching for new solutions. And everybody is confused. US is confused, Europe is confused, because the transition from old way of doing things to new way of doing things is very difficult. Nobody understands. Like Savare Hum, young Mitra Sate Vastato, Amdavad Natum, they go. According to me, world needs to be redesigned. The world was designed after World War II by America. World Bank, NATO, WIPO, WTO, GDP, GNP, per capita income, balance of payment, IMF, UN. It panchyotar varas ma badul badlai go. Badlai go because of many things. One, like Gandhi led independence movement, decolonized the entire world. Then Deng Xiaoping led combination of capitalism with communism, change China. Then Soviet Union break up and fall of Berlin Wall. Then 9/11 and then finally internet. Abhilaiho bhakta bhakta events in human history, which really requires us to think differently. But apparently we are all locked up in the past. So if we open up this conversation with younger people, I hope they can begin to think differently. And that's the purpose of our visit. I don't want to talk much. I want to really listen in the next 5 days. And then based on what we hear, we will modify manifesto. And I have said that I personally want to take interest in Gujarat's development now. At a personal level, I'm 75 years old. I don't need anything. I'm pretty well settled in life. I have wonderful children. They are doing well. I have a great wife. But I want to do something for Gujarat and India. You know, when I came here in 80s, early 80, 81, India had 2 million phones. Rajiv Gandhi gave me an opportunity to work in telecom and IT, and today we have 1 billion phones. We are a nation of connected billion people. We also produce $150 billion worth of software export every year, year after year. So I feel it is my moral duty to help and work with Congress Party. I've been very close to the family, mainly because Rajiv over a period of time became a personal friend. We worked together for 10 years. And I believe it is time to really restructure lots of things in India. And I see a great opportunity. So I hope by listening to the voices of the people, we can collectively begin to re-look at Gujarat. To me, Congress Party is all about collective leadership. Of course, Congress Party has made mistakes in the past. But it is all about collective leadership. It was collective leadership. There was no one leader. In democracy, you cannot have one leader. In dictatorship, you can. In democracy, you have to have multiple leaders. You have to listen to everybody. You have to develop consensus. And you can't say that I know all the answers and I am the one who is going to get everything done. There is no such thing. No human being is capable of doing that in a country of 1.2 billion people with the diversity we have. So it is important that we listen to the voices of the people. Many of us, I feel, the world over, democracy has been hijacked. Democracy has been hijacked because the way democracy works today, if you have 2% more vote, and if you win more seats, you have 100% say. It's true in America, it is true in Europe, it is true in India also. And democracy really belongs to people. And if we don't hear to people's voices, we can't build democratic platform. So we are here to listen. With this, I'll open up for broader conversation. Okay, this is sort of the
Shyamji,
platform.
ગુજરાતના ચીફ મિનિસ્ટર એમ કહે છે કે ગુજરાતનો વિકાસ થયો છે, સરનો વિકાસ છેલ્લા 22 વર્ષમાં જે વિકાસ થયો છે, રોડમાં છે, પાવરમાં છે, એજ્યુકેશનમાં છે, તો તમે એવું માનો છો કે આ વિકાસથી વધારે વિકાસ કરવો જરૂરી છે અથવા નહીં તો એમનો દાવો ખોટો છે?
હિન્દી મેં બતાવું બન સકે ઉઠતા લેખતા હિન્દી ઇતની અચ્છી નહીં બોલ સકતે ક્યોંકિ આદત નહીં હૈ. હિન્દી મેં બોલેંગે, ઇંગ્લિશ મેં ભી બોલેંગે, થોડા ગુજરાતી મેં બોલ દેંગે, લેકિન ક્યોંકિ સોચતે હૈ ઇંગ્લિશ મેં, ક્યોંકિ હમારે જો હમારે સબ્જેક્ટ હૈ ફિઝિક્સ ઇલેક્ટ્રોનિક્સ, ઉસમે ગુજરાતી મેં નહીં સોચ સકતે ના, તો ઇંગ્લિશ મેં સોચના પડતા હૈ, તો ઇંગ્લિશ મેં સે ફિર હિન્દી મેં ટ્રાન્સલેશન કરના પડતા હૈ દિમાગ. સો દેટ્સ વાય ઇફ આઈ મેક સમ મિસ્ટેક્સ ઇન હિયર એન્ડ ધેર, જસ્ટ બેર વિથ મી. 22 સાલ મેં પ્રોગ્રેસ તો હોના હૈ, કુછ નહીં કરો તો ભી જો 65 મિલિયન લોગ હૈ તો કરેંગે, 65 મિલિયન પીપલ દે કાન બી સિટિંગ એટ હોમ, તો પ્રોગ્રેસ તો હોના હૈ વિચ ઇઝ ગુડ, એન્ડ આઈ કાન્ટ સે દેટ નથિંગ હેઝ હેપન્ડ. ઓકે, ધેટ્સ નોટ ફેર, થિંગ્સ હેવ હેપન્ડ, બટ વી બિલીવ વી કુડ હેવ ડન લોટ મોર. વી કેન સે સેમ થિંગ અબાઉટ ઇન્ડિયા, નોટ જસ્ટ ગુજરાત. If we are happy with the progress, then I think there is something wrong. We have to be constantly unhappy with the progress. And then only you can achieve something. Okay? If we are not looking for better tomorrow, we are not doing service to our children and our grandchildren. You know, people like me have to say, we gained a lot from India. I was telling somebody, who can get a master's in physics for 1,000 rupees? That's what I paid for tuition. Just think of it. 50 years ago, I could get a master's in physics, or more than 50 years ago, for 1,000 rupees. What a great contribution India has made to me. How can I forget that? Can I create that kind of India for my children? No, it's not very difficult today. They will have to pay 5 lakh rupees or 10 lakh rupees or whatever. Education has become too expensive. Education has been privatized to a point government has withdrawn from education. Government must step in and create competitive environment for private. Baroda University was very different than it is today. Vadodara University, I don't know how many of you know, but let me tell you something which is very important, very few people know. Liquid crystal display was invented at Vadodara University by Dr. Dave. Okay, Dr. Dave was our chemistry professor. Very old man. Vidwan.
He was my neighbor.
Now, Dr. Dave never got credit for it. Can you imagine that liquid crystal display today that we all look at was invented in Vadodara? Chemistry of it. But we didn't have that knowledge of patent and capitalization and monetization and business out of it. Dr. Dave was doing research. Have we ever told this to the world, that Vadodara was the foundation of liquid crystal display? That kind of talent is gone. That kind of research doesn't exist anymore. That's what we need to do in education. Bring back those kinds of brains and give them freedom. Today, education has become too much of a commercial entity. Education, privatization, is nothing wrong with it. But when the tuitions go up, where poor people can't afford, and qualities go down, then you have to be concerned. So government must step in. Look at IITs, government owned. IIMs, government owned. So the quality education is government owned. Why can't it be in Gujarat also? This is just an example of one area called education. I told this morning that I am a son of a carpenter. When I go to Rajkot, I see all my Vishwakarma guys tinkering with metal and this and that and tools. There's a lot of talent in that group, tool industry in Rajkot. Are we really helping them innovate? Because they are all small businesses. We are doing more than enough for big guys, but we are not doing enough for little guys. Because it's easy to help big fellow. If I was a banker and I'm in charge of giving 2,000 crore loan, I can give it to two parties and I'm done. But the real value lies in giving it to 2,000 people. So our job in Gujarat is to build small industries and not worry about big ones. See, I see this whole approach as top down. So when people talk about job, they say, okay, let's get investment from abroad to create jobs, as opposed to bottom-up, and that's very Gandhian approach. We need bottom-up development and not top-down. But bottom-up is difficult. Top-down is easy. You get two big factories set up and your GDP goes up. Everybody is all excited with the numbers, but you created 10 billionaires, but you didn't lift 10 million people out of poverty. So these are the challenges for us.
आपने अभी बोला कि आपको गुजरात का विकास करना है और आप इसमें पर्सनली इंटरेस्ट ले रहे हो, तो अभी 22 साल में आपने एक बार स्वीकार भी कर रहे हो गुजरात में विकास हुआ है, तो अभी और क्या विकास करना है, अभी और क्या विकास करना चाहती है कांग्रेस
गुजरात में,
किस तरह से करना चाहिए?
देखिए, विकास तो बहुत करना है. अभी एक सिंपल बात बताऊंगा, हमारे जनरेशन के जितने लोग थे, मे बी आई एम बायस्ड, दे वर ऑल टॉल, वेरी हेल्थी. अब मैं यहां गुजरात के बच्चों को देखता हूं ना, तो मुझे शर्म आती है. छोटे हैं सब, पतले हैं सब, सब लग रहे हैं कि माल नरिष्ठ हैं ये लोग. समझे? हमारे पेरेंट्स ने, दो सब गरीब थे, उतना ध्यान दिया कि न्यूट्रिशन बच्चों को अच्छी तरह से मिल सके. इट मे बी काउज मिल्क, इट मे बी सिंपल फूड, but the modern children don't get the right nutrition. It's a big challenge. I see this as a challenge for Gujarat. And I find size of Gujarat is going down. Weight, size. You look at all the girls. And it bothers me. Okay? Nobody's concerned. I don't understand. Why can't we push nutrition as a big agenda in Gujarat? Tell our women that if you are pregnant, you must get 10 kilo weight. Children must be fed properly. Okay? You can't eat bhel puri when you are pregnant. You gotta eat the right stuff. Can we use social media for that as opposed to political gossip? This is the use of tool to do the right thing. That's a very simple idea. Nutrition for Gujarati to me is a big issue. And I can come up with 10 ideas like this. And not that I am right on every idea. But let's discuss it. Even if you implement 4 of those 10, good enough, we got to move forward. Whatever we have done is good. I just drove from Baroda, I mean from Ahmedabad to Baroda. The road is much better than I used to drive 50 years ago. So that's good. That's good progress. I'm happy with it. Doesn't matter who built it, right? Whosoever built it should get credit for it. What's wrong with it? But don't assume that it was built by politicians. It was built by people of Gujarat.
सर अगर मिस्टर शांत पित्रोड़ा की बात की जाए तो टेक्नोक्रेट से लेकर पॉलिसी थिंकर के तौर पर और एंटरप्रेन्योर के तौर पर आपकी जो भी कुछ यात्रा हुई वो अपने मेरिट पर हुई, अपने कैलिबर पर हुई। आज ऐसा क्यों है कि आपकी खुद पार्टी जो रिजर्वेशन को तवज्जो दे रही है, तो आप क्या मानते हैं, आपने आपका ओपिनियन जानना चाहते हैं?
देखिए, रिजर्वेशन अभी पार्टी डिसाइड कर रही है। लेट पार्टी डिसाइड, वट एवर पार्टी डिसाइड, आई एम ओके विद इट। But I personally believe that in this country, if you are convinced, you can get things done without anything. I didn't follow any reservation. I'm OBC. I never used it. Never used it in my life, here or in America. America also I'm minority. Never used it. So it is possible in democracy to rise without any support. But if you have support, it's okay, but you can't get hung up on only support. Okay? अभी क्या हो रहा है अपनी सोसाइटी में, सब लोग कह रहे हैं कि सरकार हमारे लिए क्या करेगी, हम कुछ नहीं करेंगे। राजीव गांधी के टाइम में मैं एक दफा यूपी गया था, तब तो मैं प्राइम मिनिस्टर का सलाहकार था, तो पूरे गांव में 300 लोग आ गए, डंडा बंडा लगा के, मैं जयराम रमेश सब गए, तो मुखिया गांव का खड़ा होकर बोलने लगा कि साहब हमारी तो टीचर चली गई है, हमारा डॉक्टर नहीं है, सब प्रॉब्लम लिस्ट किया उसने। उनको ऐसा था कि प्राइम मिनिस्टर का सलाहकार है, बोलेगा कि चिंता मत करिए, हम दिल्ली जाके आपका सब प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व कर देंगे। तो जब मेरा टर्न आया बोलने का, मैंने बताया कि देखो भाई, हमारे बच्चे जहां जाते हैं स्कूल में, वहां तो टीचर रोज आता है, हमारी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी कभी नहीं जाती, हम तो मजा कर रहे हैं, हम आपका प्रॉब्लम क्या सॉल्व करेंगे, आप करो आपका प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व यार। जस्ट बिकॉज आई एम प्राइम मिनिस्टर एडवाइजर, डोंट एक्सपेक्ट मी टू सॉल्व योर प्रॉब्लम। बिटर ट्रूथ। आई सेड, हैवंट यू लर्न्ड इट दैट यू मस्ट टेक रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फॉर योर कम्युनिटी। वी डोंट डू इनफ ऑफ दैट। वी एक्सपेक्ट government to solve all our problems. Government can solve only certain problems. Until community, when we were growing up, local teacher was hired by local community, not by Delhi. So we have to decentralize everything. In Gujarat, if I had an option, I would further decentralize. Hamare wahan kya hoga, over a period of time we have centralized government too much. Delhi is prime minister, in every state it is chief minister. The power has to be decentralized to a district level. District should plan. Every district is 2 million people roughly. There are 600 some odd districts. Each district should plan their own agenda. We have not decentralized. This is what Gandhi used to talk about. Gandhi's idea of governance was decentralization, local consideration. अभी तो क्या हो गया कि योर टोमेटो कम्स फ्रॉम चाइना, फनी थिंग, बट दैट्स द काइंड ऑफ सिस्टम यू हैव। योर टोमेटो शुड कम फ्रॉम योर बैकयार्ड ना, ओके? सो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट टू लोकलाइज, व्हाट टू ग्लोबलाइज। अभी तो ब्लाइंडली वी आर ग्लोबलाइजिंग एवरीथिंग। सो दीज आर द काइंड ऑफ डिस्कशंस वी नीड टू हैव विद पीपल।
सर हम एक साइड टेक्नोलॉजी को आगे बढ़ाने की बात कर रहे हैं, इस बार का चुनाव जो है जातिवाद के आधार पर लड़ा जा रहा है, तो ये इसको कैसे देखते हैं सर आप?
क्या बोले
सर, जातिवाद के आधार पर
कास्टिज्म? देखो, इंडिया में कास्टिज्म हैज बीन गोइंग ऑन फॉर थाउजेंड्स ऑफ इयर्स। we haven't yet gotten out of it. Okay. This is the baggage we are carrying as a society.
So why would you
mean that? But don't you think it is dangerous?
Well, ideally you might want to get out of it, but you are today in the middle of it. Over a period of time, when you get more education, more freedom, more understanding, people will say, we have arrived, we have reached. It is based on insecurity, based on the fact that I didn't get enough, I want more. That's the mindset. देखिए भैया ये सब एक बात सुनिए कि देर इज नो छप्पन साथी वाला एक नेता हुई गेट और
नहीं नहीं मतलब कोई भी नहीं है जो हमें
इट रिक्वायर्स कलेक्टिव डिसीजन ऑल ऑफ दीज टॉपिक्स रिक्वायर कलेक्टिव कंसेंसस ये चीज भैया एक यू आर ऑल लुकिंग एट रॉन्ग पर्सनल यार आई मे बी रॉन्ग इन सेइंग दिस बट आई बिलीव यू कैन नॉट रन दिस कंट्री बेस्ड ऑन वन मैन दिस कंट्री इज टू कॉम्प्लेक्स भाई टू डाइवर्स It should be collective decision making. I always give this example of Gandhiji's time. Gandhiji, Sardar Patel, Nehru, Maulana Azad, Netaji Bose, Sarojini Naidu. There were so many leaders. Abhi toh kya ho gaya hai? It is personality cult. This versus that. It doesn't work that way. You cannot have democracy which is based on personality cult. A versus B. What kind of a government is that? What kind of democracy is that when a billion people, you are talking about one man versus another man. Doesn't make sense anymore. So,
Congress,
I'm reservations. You agree that it should be the agenda or not?
When we submitted our report on Knowledge Commission, we had a recommendation on reservations. Supreme Court came in, decided something else. It's okay then, Supreme Court decision is good decision, bhai. Follow it, na? See, everything I say doesn't have to be right. So reservation would be decided based on party's consensus. Party will decide whatever party decides. It's okay.
So look at party to sir vote bank ko dekhti hai apna reason deti na sir.
But party will have to decide that na bhai.
Samaj ka jo bandhan hai usko to nahi dekhti wo to apna vote bank dekhti hai sir.
Party then vote bank will tell them. Vote bank should tell them.
Lekin logo ko sir sahi लोगों को सही रास्ते पे ले जाना वही तो लीडर का काम है अगर नहीं है पता है सब लोगों को
नो आई डोंट थिंक नहीं पता है दे हैव देयर ओन इक्वेशन अरे पिछले इक्वेशन
ये कांग्रेस खाम थियरी क्यों फिर से रिवाइव कर रही है
खाम
थियरी
यार हरिजन आई एम नॉट इन टू कास्ट सो लेट्स मूव अवे फ्रॉम कास्ट डिस्कशन ओके आई एम नॉट इन टू कास्ट पर्सनली
दैट इज देयर द पार्टी टू बीन 156 149 से ड्यूरिंग मनोसी रूल
दैट इज फाइन ओके दैट इज अ पार्टी डिसीजन आई एम नॉट इन टू कास्ट personally. And I am a wrong guy to comment on caste. Okay? To be very frank.
No,
I never took advantage of caste. I still believe in democracy. You can rise if you have the guts to rise. But it's okay.
No, आप ये manifesto में समाज करेंगे कि इतना हम नहीं
सोचते हैं। तो जो manifesto सब लिखेंगे उनको पता चलेगा ना।
अच्छा।
I will give one input.
सर एक ऐसा हो सकता है कि सर जैसे गैस सब्सिडी छोड़ने की एक अपील करी तो वैसे एक अपील होनी चाहिए कि जो रिजर्वेशन मिल गया है और वो अच्छा कर रहे हैं तो उनको अपना रिजर्वेशन छोड़ के जो आर्थिक तौर पे कमजोर
है दे हैव टू डिसाइड ना
नहीं ऐसा हो सकता है
इट्स अप टू इंडिविजुअल देखो इन माय टाइम आई कुड हैव अप्लाइड फॉर ए स्कॉलरशिप बेस्ड ऑन स्केड्यूल कास्ट आई डिडंट अप्लाई इट वाज माय डिसीजन
लेकिन आपकी तो किसी और को तो नहीं मिलना जिसको चाहिए थी मैं कह रहा हूँ कि किसी और आपकी छोड़ के जैसे सब्सिडी छोड़ी जिसको रिक्वायर थी उसको मिल गई तो ऐसा जो मांग रहे हैं उसको मिल जानी
चाहिए कास्ट लेट्स गेट आउट ऑफ कास्ट डिस्कशन लेट्स मूव ऑन टू सम अदर टॉपिक
अच्छा आप ये मानते हैं कि बीजेपी में आप
समबडी हेल्प ऑल्सो आस्क क्वेश्चन
डिजिटल इंडिया की बात करी ने मोदी सरकार है जाने देश नो विकास थी गये तरफ नो एजेंडा तरफ लई जाय छे तो नोटबंदी की असर अत्यारे कितनी डिजिटल इंडिया ने
जो पहला तो एक वस्तु समझो वो क्लियरली डिजिटल इंडिया वर्षो पहला शुरू थे आई डोंट नो वेदर यू रेड माय बायोग्राफी इन माय बायोग्राफी देयर इज अ चैप्टर ऑन डिजिटल इंडिया ओके डिजिटल इंडिया એ આજનું નથી થયું ઘણી વખત શું હોય કે તમે છે ને બીજ વાવો પણ યુ મે નોટ ગેટ ધ ફ્રૂટ્સ ધેટ આર લાઈફ વર્ક્સ યુ પ્લાન્ટ સીડ્સ then it grows, somebody gets the shadow, and somebody else gets the fruit. But you have to plant seeds. The fellow who plants seeds doesn't wait for the fruits. He has to go plant other seeds. And there are some who picked the fruit and said, I did it. It's wrong. Okay. It's wrong. Satya Chaya. But it's okay.
Did you write that one book? Did you write that one book or you are like that?
No, that's different. That I wrote a long time ago. But there is a book on my life which talks about Rajiv Gandhi's era. Okay, it's called Dreaming Big. There is a Gujarati translation also. Dreaming Big, My Journey to Connect India. Where I have an entire chapter on digital India. How did it start? Where are we? What did you do on UID, infrastructure, connectivity to panchayat, all the things we talked about. But it's okay for somebody to say, I picked up the fruit and I did it. It's okay as long as people of India benefit. It's okay. Be generous.
So Rahul Gandhi told Gujarat recently, a lot of times, and he even said that, you know, his speeches and these are attracting people, they are, you know, he's gathering more people. What is your view on that?
I thought we were here to collect input on manifesto. Okay. Rahul Gandhi attracting crowd. You can see it on the picture, na? Who am I to say? But I have not seen all the photographs. Okay. You may have seen more photographs. I have seen few. And from those pictures it looks like he is getting a big crowd. Based on pictures I have seen. But I have not seen every picture. Okay. So, you figure it out whether he got bigger crowd in Surat or bigger crowd in Dam Jungle. I don't know.
But do you think that, so because you are going in elections, so this will benefit the party?
People of Gujarat will have to decide that. Ultimately, people of Gujarat will decide. But all I want to do is tell people of Gujarat to think. Don't outsource your thinking. See, people have tendency to outsource their thinking to few media channels. That fellow says, good, it's good. I mean, you have brain. Use it, na? If you come to that conclusion, it's okay. But don't come to conclusion because social media said this, or television channel said that, or that article said it. You are intelligent enough? My father, who was fourth grade educated, was very intelligent. You don't need PhD to be intelligent. Okay? Illiterate people are also very intelligent. So they have to make decisions. Based on who can I trust? Where is the future? How do I see the situation in the country today? Where do I get comfort? Who can I trust? Who lies, who doesn't lie? All of these issues are important to people.
You also said about NS University, Thoda Institute, you said, and it said that it was different when you
were there. It was very different.
Right, and it's now. So where do you think, you think that the education policies in Gujarat are lagging, a lot of privatizing is happening. What is your view?
I think education in Gujarat needs a lot more government investment. You look at, why did Gujarat lose on IT? Somebody has to ask that question. Why did Bangalore win on IT? I'll give my layman's answer to that. One, Bangalore had very good education institutions. Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore Institute of Technology, you know, Visvesvaraya Institute of Technology, all that along with space research, Indian telephone industry, BEL. You had that ecosystem and infrastructure, that was one. Two, English speaking talent. In Gujarat, people do not speak English well. Period. I meet lot of Gujarat graduates, can't write a sentence or can't understand a word. What kind of graduate is he? If you had degree in physics in my generation, you spoke very good English. You have no options. Today you can get a master's in Gujarat in physics, won't understand two paragraphs of English. If you don't understand English, you have a problem in global market. It is good to love your language, but it is not good to reject English. I'll give you one very simple example. When I graduated in 64 with a master's, President Radhakrishnan was our convocation speaker. I still remember as a young boy. You are impressed, you know, President of India is coming, you are a young kid, you have no idea of this world. And you are listening to this President Radha Krishna. You know what he said? In his speech, you can go refer to his speech. He, at that time, there was a Gujarat, Mahagujarat movement had just done. So everybody was pushing for Gujarati, Gujarati. President Radha Krishna said that people go abroad to learn science and they have to learn another language. Here in Gujarat, you are talking about learning only one language. You must learn English. You can refer to his speech. Okay? Gujarat doesn't teach English very well. You have a problem. Accept it. But they don't want to accept it. So we have to really push for education reforms. Not just in colleges, but in schools as well. In vocational education and many areas.
ચાર શહેરોમાં જો છો, રાજ્યના ચાર શહેરોમાં લોકોના વિચારો જાણવા જઈએ, ગ્રામીણ લોકોનું શું, ગ્રામીણ ક્ષેત્રના મતદારો છે, નાગરિકો, એમના વિચારોને કેવી રીતે?
અમારું એવું માનવું છે કે શહેરમાં લોકો જે ગામડા જેવા છે, બહુ ભરત નથી, બહુ જાજો ભરત નથી. તમે કેટલી જગ્યાએ જઈ શકો? એટલે વી ડિસાઈડેડ કે વીલ ગો ટુ ફાઈવ પ્લેસીસ. મે બી ઇટ નોટ એનફ. યુ કેન બ્લેમ મી ફોર ઇટ કે દરેક ગામડે ગામડે કેમ નથી ગયા, કઈ નથી જઈ શક્યા, શું કરીએ, માફ કરો. પણ કોંગ્રેસના લોકો ગામડે ગામડે જઈ આવ્યા છે, હું નથી કહો, બીજા લોકો જઈ આવ્યા છે.
સર, તમે જેમ કહ્યું કે રાજીવ ગાંધી સાથે તમે આટલા વર્ષ સુધી કામ કર્યું, હવે રાહુલ ગાંધી કોંગ્રેસનું ફ્યુચર મનાય છે. ઘણા બધા લોકો એવું માને છે કે પોલિટિકલી ઇનમેચ્યોર છે હજી રાહુલ ગાંધી, અને ગુજરાતની ચૂંટણીમાં પણ કોંગ્રેસ માટે મહત્વનો રોલ પ્લે કરી રહ્યા છે રાહુલ ગાંધી. પોલિટિકલ ફ્યુચર કઈ રીતે એમનું જુઓ છો?
યુ ફર્સ્ટ ઓફ ઓલ આઈ મસ્ટ સે આઈ એમ બાયસ્ડ બીકોઝ આઈ નો હિમ ટુ વેલ. ફર્સ્ટ આઈ હેવ નોન હિમ એવર સિન્સ હી વોઝ અ યંગ બોય. કોન્ટ્રરી ટુ વોટ મીડિયા હેઝ ક્રિએટેડ, he is 180 degrees opposite. He is highly educated. Pela apna Subramanian Swami anke kya avan che, he gets media coverage, but Subramanian Swami is lying and lies self. He is a graduate from best of the best universities. He is highly literate. He reads a lot. Once I remember, he asked me to bring 10 books from US. I gave him 10 books and he had read every one of those. He's a thinking fellow. He's low-key. He's not into media flashy coverage. He's comfortable with himself. His words are absolutely, he's politically highly mature. But politics of India is very different from politically mature person. Politics of India is very different. Right? People can say you are politically not mature. If I lie, I am politically mature. If I cheat, if I manipulate, if I tell you one thing and do exactly opposite, I am very smart.
એટલે ઘણા લોકો એટલે આવે એવું માને છે કે મોદી સામે તો પછી કેમ નથી ચાલતું
રહ્યું. ગમે તે હોય એ માટે આપે જૂઠું બોલવાની કાંઈ જરૂર નથી. ખોટે ખોટા કોઈને એટેક નથી કરવાની જરૂર. ઓકે, યુ હેવ ટુ બી ગાર્જિયન અબાઉટ ધીઝ થિંગ્સ. ઓકે, તમારે જે કરવું એ કરો, ઇટ ઇઝ યોર પ્રિવિલેજ. આઈ હેવ ટુ ડુ વોટ આઈ હેવ ટુ.
મારો સીધો સવાલ એ છે કે સત્તામાં કેમ નથી આવતું?
જો સત્તા એ રિલેટિવ વસ્તુ છે. કોંગ્રેસ કેટલા વર્ષ સત્તામાં હતી યાદ કરો? બીજેપી કેટલા વર્ષ સત્તામાં હતી? યુ હેવ ધ આન્સર ના? So it's okay in democracy to be down for a while.
Sir, वो इतना पढ़ते हैं और इतना इतना आप कह रहे हैं कि इतना स्टडी भी करते हैं, इतना होमवर्क कर लेते, तो फिर वो जो कल फोटो ट्विटर पे डाला, ऐसी सिली मिस्टेक क्यों करते
हैं? आपकी फोटो क्यों पहने देगा?
वो जो नोटबंदी वाली जो फोटो डाली,
मुझे पता नहीं. तो वो करने कोई मिस्टेक, इट इज ओके टू मेक अ मिस्टेक यार. इन लाइफ वाई शुड यू नॉट मेक मिस्टेक? आई मेक मिस्टेक ऑल द टाइम. इट इज गुड टू मेक मिस्टेक्स. फेल्यूअर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ सक्सेस. If you are afraid to fail, don't try anything, na? Yeah, you are too demanding on everything.
ઓકે સર, હી ઇઝ ઓલસો નોર્મલ હ્યુમન બીંગ લાઈક યુ. આઈ એમ નોટ એટેકિંગ એનીબડી.
બીજેપી
150 કરોડ ટાર્ગેટ છે, આપ કેટલી અપેક્ષા રાખો છો કોંગ્રેસને? ભલે એવી કેપેબિલિટી ટુ જજ, ઓકે, આઈ એમ નોટ ક્વોલિફાઈડ.
કોંગ્રેસ સરકાર બનતી ઉમીદ છે.
આઈ એમ હોપિંગ, આઈ એમ હોપિંગ.
સીટો કેટલી આવે કોંગ્રેસ
નથી ખબર, કેટલી આવડત નથી, ડોબા છીએ, કેટલી આવડત નથી, કારણ કે તમે પછી નથી બોક્સો. ઓકે
ભાઈ,
એવું લખો કે ડોબા છીએ, એનો વાંધો નથી. બોલો
સરજી, તમે કીધું કે પ્રજા નક્કી કરશે, પણ મારું માનવું છે કે પ્રજાને સારો ઉમેદવાર બી આપવો પડશે સામે.
કેન્ડિડેટ તો કરવા જ પડશે ને ભાઈ.
અત્યારની પરિસ્થિતિ એવી છે કે નેતા સુધી લડતા નથી, લડે છે તો નેતા જીતવા દેતા નથી.
મિનિસ્ટરો લડે છે
એકદમ સાદો
ઉમેદવાર આપવામાં આવે છે.
હવે તો કરશે જે પાર્ટીને કરવાનું છે, આપણે વાત કરો ને, તને ખર્ચમાં શું કરવું છે એની વાત કરો.
ઇન્ટરવ્યુ જાય છે.